1935, we had a huge World's Fair. This whole area got a whole rebirth. The fair ended in the red. People lost a lot of money, but it cleaned up the area, and we have so many new hotels and the convention center, and it's huge. It goes along the river, the convention center. And South Peters will change to North Peters when we cross into the French Quarter. I want you to understand that the French Quarter, also called the Vieux Carré, the old square, okay, this is the original city. It's the original street plan laid out in 1722, and 1718 is when the colony was founded. It was named after the Regent of France, who was the Duke of Orleans. Who has been beatified, free woman of color. She started an order of nuns, the Sisters of the Holy Family, and she had a school, an orphanage, and was an educator.
Yeah. I can't help but thinking when the sun used to shine in my back door. Now the sun has turned to rain on my laughter.
It's on piers, so they're raised, and under the house they run the plumbing for the house. We don't get a whole lot of cold weather, and if we get an overnight freeze, our weatherman will tell us you got to protect your pipes. It is a 622 square mile lake, 41 miles long, 23 miles wide, and it's brackish water. That's a combination of fresh water and salt water. Look at the cranes, and look at the metal they're pounding down. They're building the permanent pumps right here that the water will be pumped into the lake, our rainwater. It'll be 9 years in August, and we're still doing work. We have a point of a 24-mile bridge. One side, one of the bridges, two lanes going over, 1950s, the other one 1960s, and people travel that bridge every day. They're crossovers. If you need to turn around, they live in St. Tammany Parish. 42 cemetery. It's nothing living right next to a cemetery because they're all over our neighborhood.
Tradition of burying people above ground comes from the swampy conditions around here.
And three spots here, so they'll go in this way, so you can take a peek.
This is an exceptional collection of sculptures from all over the world.
Every time it rains, they have to pump the water back up over the levees to keep our city from flooding. These big levees extend 1,200 miles. They protect the inland areas from severe weather conditions. of spring water floods and autumn hurricanes. The Creole Queen is not a steamboat, folks, like the Natchez. She's a diesel electric paddle wheeler. So you folks made the right choice. You're on the real boat.
I will travel down to his door for near value, and it goes back here into the Man Shack Swamp. That's the name of the swamp y'all come out in today. It's called Man Shack Swamp. It covers about 5,000 acres of swamp back here. It covers both sides of Interstate 10. You got the edge of the lake, got the railroad tracks. You come back out of Highway 51 up here. Big area called Man Shack. But it isn't part of this. There are snakes and frogs and fishes and all. Now they recognize the voice and all that. They know our voices, the gesture and all, the colors of the boat and everything. And down the bayou where I live, I was back all about your pony sham. You got Bayou LaFouche and Poker Dream and Gulag and Chack Bay, Chaco Hula. And the Spanish moss is an air plant. And we're going to go along. There's some trees you see loaded down with Spanish moss, and there's some trees you don't see yet.
The girls don't have their own territories, but the boys do?
Right, the boys do that. And right now, they're standing here. Look already.
Yeah. Oh, my word.
We're going to have to beat him.
But that's not Big Bob.
Here you go.
Just gotta wait and see who else we're gonna get. Come on, come on. Whoop, whoop. Yep, yep. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Whoop, whoop.
Know that, right?
Now, see this locator right here? Now, that's a male. Now, he fogged. He probably 3 years from doing any kind of business. But when I see him posture up the whole deal, see, that's a little male, that one. I know him. See, the leg is going probably in snagger two's belly. They got a gator we see here sometimes. We call it snagger two. And skinning gators, there is a procedure and technique to that. You can't skin it wrong. If you skin it wrong, you lose a lot of your money. The fish jump, though, I'm worse than y'all, but I can't resist. The other day after they made it with Big Boy, they went up on the side right where that gator's at, where they got two, three of them in there. Okay, now that ain't neither one of the honey buns there, but them three big females, they got some. They let the animals go by 3 or 4 times all day long. It gets to the point where the gator's looking at that like, you know, the squirrel sees, oh, you've been there all day. And the gator's like, yeah, come on in, bro, it's cool. Oh, man. Just took the gator eating that. Look, he's bait. And he said, come and get it. It's still good. Now, see what I was telling you? See, the raccoon's looking. I ain't falling for that. What's that?
Look at that. She looks like she wants it.
Good to see the girl. Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
playing with the marshmallow, too.
That's a male, that one. See the little tail, fluffy, fuzzy the tail?
Uh-oh.
That's some of the mating
bones.
Oh, he's eyeballing something there. Little luminous feather up top the head. It's a solid critter. That belly ain't full of air. That's a solid critter right there. That's a nice gator. Now, when we got this one about 2 years ago, it was out of an egg about 2 months old. We had some little baby ones. We got 6 of them that we used for the tour. They come out of an egg, you know, gators lay eggs. They come out of the egg, maybe 7-8 inches long, little thing. And then 2 years later, what you see there, about 2 feet long, 2 years old. And we got them taped up. The jaws are taped up so it cannot bite. You know, and there's a live animal. Now, if it creeps you out, don't bother. I know some people said, we'd look at yesterday. We ain't touching that. What you took it off of? I don't know. Tell you, man, we'll hold it, take a picture with it. You know, some people are not into it, so you got to watch who you got sometime, you know. But if you want, you hold like that and take your picture. You hold with 2 hands, by the front legs and by the tail. It's going to wiggle around some. You know, it's a live animal. It ain't dead. You know? But like I said, the jaws are taped. They can't do nothing. Yeah, the kingfish, it's because you see the orange legs on it too?
Yeah.
They get a little color to the leg, got the little, the wings thing and all. Because the meat is cut so small, that's what gives the flavor why it's so tender, but she diced up meat into a small, small piece of all walrus. You cook through me with the bone, you never get your teeth through it. It's a tough stuff.
What was here was swamp. What was in the swamp was cypress. Each one of those beams represents a whole cypress tree. And you can see that they've been chopped out by hand. Now, it's on the table. And here we meet Marguerite. Again, we know more about the enslaved people than we know about the family. We know that Marguerite came to this plantation as one of the first slaves in 1790. We know that she was sold away from a husband and two children. We also know when she got here, she got another husband and three children.
Sweet chariot.
Back in this area, that building over there is the kitchen. Every plantation had separate kitchens for obvious reasons. Fire, heat, odor. But back in this area was what we call the village or the dependencies. All of the outbuildings that were necessary to operate this plantation shop. The blacksmith, the carpenter, the veterinary, everything, the hospital. And they were getting rows with big spaces in between for gardens. The enslaved people pretty well took care of their own eating. They were able to feed themselves. Now, you can see there's two sides to each cabin with one fireplace. You see there's only one chimney. The question is, how many people lived in a side? The answer is a family. If there were five in a family, there'd be five in a side. If there was only two, there'd be two.
Yeah, it's a gentleman from Newcastle.